Hi everyone. In this lesson, we are going to talk about two different grammar structures. The first one is feature in the past, and the second one is indirect questions. Let's start with the first one, feature in the past. Feature in the past is sometimes described as the feature seen from the past. It's used to express the idea that in the past you thought something would happen in the future. It doesn't matter if you are correct or not. Let's check these sentences together now. For example, somebody thinks about the future, so he or she says, I will be meeting her later on. But sometime later, we look back at him thinking about the future. This time, he or she has to say, he knew he would be meeting her later on. We can use the following forms and more in feature in the past. We simply change the form to a past one. When we want to express feature in the past, we use the past of the normal feature forms. Don't forget about it. When we want to express feature in the past, we use the past of the normal feature forms. For example, just remember, normally we use will for feature simple, and this time will changes to would. Or am is are going to for feature changes to was or were going to, or present continuous for feature am is are doing, for example, changes to past continuous form was or were doing. Let's check these forms together one by one. And the first one is would. In subordinate clauses, it's just the past form of will. And whether it happened or not depends on the context. For example, I knew it would be a bad day. Just remember, we have to use the past form of the normal feature forms. So here, would is the past form of will. And the second form is was or were to. When we use was or were to plus infinitive form of the verb, it means there was an arrangement for something to happen. It's usually formal. For example, the meeting was to take place on Monday. And the other form that we can use is was or were going to. This time, this is the past form of am is are going to. And was or were going to is used to talk about plans we made in the past, which didn't happen or won't happen in the future. For example, I was going to visit my aunt when I went to England, but she had gone to Spain for the summer, so I didn't visit her. And the other form is past continuous form. This is the present continuous. This is the past form of present continuous. Just remember, we use also present continuous for feature. And this is the past form of present continuous. So past continuous is used to talk about confirmed plans or arrangements. For example, I lost my passport the day before we were leaving for our honeymoon. Or, sorry, I forgot we were having dinner together today. These are confirmed plans or arrangements. And the last form is was or were about to. Was or were about to is used to inform someone that you were going to do something, but another event prevented you from doing it. For example, I was about to leave when the phone rang. And she was about to tell us everything, but her husband stopped her. So here, as you see, your action, your event is prevented by another event. There is an exercise here for you. Please choose the most suitable form to refer to the feature in the past to complete the sentences with the verbs in brackets below. Please read the sentences carefully and try to find the most suitable form to refer to the feature in the past. Okay, let's check your answers together. The first one, I saw he had a gun, but I didn't think he was going to shoot. Just remember, M is are going to. We use it to talk about future intentions or plans, just remember. And here, the past equivalent of M is are going to is was or were going to. So, was going to is the most suitable form that refers to the feature in the past here. And the second one, I knew you would fail the exam. I knew you would fail the exam. Just remember, will. We use will to make predictions about things that we think will happen. And so the past equivalent of will is would. So the correct answer here is would fail. And the third one, that night, I was very excited because the next morning, I was going back home on the first train. And question four, she promised she would put an end to the situation, but failed to do so. And also just remember, normally we use will for promises and refusals. And here, the past form of will is would. That's why the most suitable answer is she promised she would put an end to the situation. And five, she was about to finish her speech when someone threw an egg at her and her action is prevented or was prevented by another action here. That's why the correct answer is was about to. And question six, the couple who died in the fire were getting married at the end of the month. And the last one, a family of six who were to move out the following week died when the building collapsed. So here the most suitable form is were to for the future in the past. Let's go on with the second subject, indirect questions. As you know, direct questions are the normal questions that we can ask friends, family members, and people who we know well. But indirect questions are a more polite way to ask for information or make requests. We often use them when asking something to strangers or people we don't know well. We also use them when asking for a favor from friends, and also there are a few grammatical changes with indirect questions. We use indirect questions with WH question words like when, where, what, how, or why, or with auxiliary verbs, yes or no questions, like am, is, are, was, were, do, does, did, have, has, or had. You can use all tenses in indirect questions. Also, we use some phrases. Use a phrase to introduce your indirect questions. For example, do you know? Or can you tell me? Could you tell me? I'd like to know. Or I wonder. These are some phrases that we can use to introduce our indirect questions. Let's check the examples. Where is the cinema? As you see, it's a kind of direct question. Where is the cinema? Just remember, for direct questions, we use WH question word at the beginning of a sentence, and then the suitable auxiliary verb, and then the object or the subject. Where is the cinema? This is a kind of direct question. And When we want to use this direct question in indirect question, first we put the most suitable phrase at the beginning of the sentence. So it can be, for example, can you tell me? And then we use WH question word after the phrase. And then this time we use first the subject, then the correct auxiliary verb at the end of the sentence. Remember, in direct questions, first we use WH question word, and then the correct auxiliary verb, and then the subject. But for indirect questions, first we use the most suitable phrase, and after this phrase, we use WH question word, and this time, after the WH question word, we use the subject and then the verb. Another example, what do you like about the film? What do you like about the film? It's a kind of direct question, as you see. And it's a kind of sentence in simple present tense. So, I wonder, this can be our suitable phrase. And then the correct, again, the same WH question word. And then the subject. And this time, we don't use the auxiliary verb here. Just we use the verb. And this is a kind of sentence in simple present tense. That's why the correct indirect question is, I wonder what you like about the film. When there's no question word, if it's a kind of yes or no question this time, we have to use if or whether with the indirect questions. For example, do you know him? Do you know him? We don't have any WH question word, as you see. It's a kind of auxiliary verb, yes or no question. And then the correct indirect sentence is, I'd like to know, this time we have to use if or whether instead of the auxiliary verb. I'd like to know if or whether you know him. And the second example, did they show you the way? It's a kind of sentence, it's a kind of question in simple past tense. And again, we don't have any WH question word. And the correct indirect sentence is, I wonder if or whether they showed you the way. First, we use the correct phrase, and then because of not having WH question word, we have to use if or whether, and then the subject, and then the correct form of the verb according to the tense. I wonder if or whether they showed you the way. We can use indirect questions with all tenses. Let's check them together. These are the direct questions, and we will do these direct questions like indirect questions. Let's start with simple present tense. Where do you live? Where do you live? First, you can use the correct suitable phrase at the beginning. Can you tell me where you live? Or where does your brother live? I'd like to know where your brother lives. Let's go on with simple past tense. When did you arrive? I wonder when you arrive. First, the most suitable phrase, and then WH question word, and the subject, and the correct form of the verb. What did your mother prepare for lunch? Can you tell me what your mother prepared for lunch? And for future, what will your sister do next winter? Do you know what your sister will do next winter? When is she going to Brazil? And do you know when she is going to Brazil? And let's go on with present perfect tense. Where has Marta gone? Could you tell me where Marta has gone? And the last one, Where have you been? I'd like to know where you have been. For present perfect, just be careful. We use the correct phrase again, and then the WH question word. And first we use subject, and then the correct form of the verb. There's an exercise here. Write indirect questions by using the expressions I'd like to know, I wonder, do you know, can or could you tell me? Please try first on your own, then we can check your answers. Let's start the first one. Why did she cry? As you see, it's a kind of direct question. Why did she cry? Let's change it into indirect question. Can you tell me is the phrase here? And then you have to use first WH question word, and then the subject, and then the correct form of the verb. So the answer is, can you tell me why she cried? Can you tell me why she cried? Why, WH question word, she is the subject and cried is the correct type of the verb here, verb two. Why? Because it's a kind of simple past tense. And the second one, when will they get married? When will they get married? I wonder when they will get married. And the third one, how long has she known him? Be careful, it's a kind of present perfect tense. How long has she known him? I'd like to know how long she has known him. And question four, do they have any free tickets? And this time, be careful, we don't have any WH question words here. So it's a kind of auxiliary verb, yes, no question. So just remember, we use this time if or whether in indirect question. So do you know if they have or whether they have any free tickets? And question five, which countries did she visit? Do you know which countries she visited? Okay, let's go on with others. Please, again, read the direct questions carefully and try to write the correct indirect questions. Okay, let's start. Have you seen my dog? Again, it's a kind of yes, no question and present perfect tense. Be careful. So I wonder if you have seen my dog. I wonder if you have seen my dog. And question seven, why do you like traveling so much? Why do you like? And we have a WH question word here. I'd like to know why you like traveling so much. Why you like traveling so much? First WH question word and then subject and then the correct form of the verb. Question eight, did you finish the report? Could you tell me if or whether you finished the report? And question nine, was he late for the meeting? Was he late for the meeting? Again, it's a kind of yes-no question with an auxiliary verb. So, do you know if or whether he was late for the meeting? And the last one, when will she start her new job? Can you tell me when she will start her new job? So, as you see, these are the direct questions and these are the indirect questions. And don't forget about it. For indirect questions, first we use a suitable phrase at the beginning of a sentence, and then if we have a WH question word, we use it. After this WH question word, we use the subject and then the suitable form of the verb according to the tense of the direct question. If we don't have any WH question words, this time we use if or whether. Thanks for listening. That's all for today.